back here to join the Boss Man Show. But joined by the Purdue Fort Wayne head coach. He's a coach who has ties to our area, the Atlanta area. Coach John Kaufman. Coach Kaufman, how are things up there in Fort Wayne, man?
Well, I promise you, it's a little cooler than it is down there in Atlanta. It's 27 degrees right now in Fort Wayne, and it's supposed to get down to negative 10 on Wednesday. So, I don't know if you've ever felt negative 10, have you?
Yes, I did, Coach. Last year's Super Bowl in Minnesota, I sure did.
Okay. Well, it's a little different from my days growing up in Dunwoody and going to Marist High School. So, I love my time in Atlanta, and I'm excited for you to have me on your show.
And, Coach, you know, it's like I said, it's good to talk to somebody who has ties to the area because, Coach, like I told you off the air, Coach, a lot of people come on the show and tell me about it. It's the traffic, the varsity, and your Waffle House. That's what I usually hear about when I have guests on the show, Coach. I know those three things.
Oh, yeah, that's right up my alley. I love all three.
Amen there, Coach. And Taco Mac as well. Another local thing here that I love. Taco Mac and Tim Lizzie's as well, Coach.
I don't know if I'm allowed to say this or not on your show, but I'm a big fan of Sweetwater 420, too.
Hey, yes you can, Coach. It's all good. It's all good, Coach. I'm telling you, it's all good, man. It's good to have you on the show, Coach. Now, I said, Coach, I saw your team, man. I saw you all making improvements. I want to have you on the show because I see you all 5-3. Some of the league players come off winning against Denver. Never had on Coach Bossman Show before as well. So talk to me, Coach. What's been the key factors for your team this year in the summer league play, being 5-3, getting off this good start, and being the thick of things with South Dakota State, South Dakota, those teams like that in the league, Coach?
Well, I really like our group, and we have 10 newcomers, and so I know there's going to be continued growth as we go through. We got off to a hot start. We were 4-0 in the league, and that included a 16-point win at home against South Dakota State, who was picked to win our league. And the two of us have been toward the top of the league for the last really 4 or 5, 6 years. It's been South Dakota State, Fort Wayne, North Dakota State, and in the last 2 years, South Dakota's had really good years. And so, you know, we've been up towards the top, but unfortunately, we had a little bit of a run into some tough road trips and ended up dropping a couple, but had a great Denver win on Saturday for our homecoming, which, kind of put us back on the right track. So, love this group. We're led by two seniors, one of which, John Conchar's, kind of on. He's on most NBA teams' radar. Talked to 17 NBA franchises this offseason. He's actually the only player in the nation since 1992, when they kept all of these stats, to have over 1,800 points, 1,000 rebounds, 400 assists, and 200 steals. And he's having a phenomenal year this year, leading our league in assists, second in rebounds, plays the point guard at 6'5", and he's averaging close to 20 a game. And then we have another senior, Cason Harrell, who's from Pittsburgh, and he's having an all-league caliber year as well, averaging about 18 points a game. And, those two are leading, in the scoring column, but also just by example with these 10 newcomers. But, we're top 20 in the country in scoring, top 20 in the country in three-pointers and assists. And so, we've got an explosive offense, and I really like we've shown some depth with some of these newcomers taking on big roles or bigger roles, and we've started getting some critical stops down the stretch. So I like our progress, and I like where we stand right now in the Summit League.
And, Coach, like you said, your progress, I feel like player development is so key, Coach, for any roster, especially at the mid-major level, because, you don't get those blue-chip, top-notch recruits that Duke of Carolina gets. And so you have to develop your players, final diamond in the rough, the JUCO route, transfer route, a high school freshman coming in from high school. So and I feel like the newcomers offseason is going to be very key for these guys to develop in your system even more. Those two studs you have leaving after this year, Coach.
No doubt. And both of them, ironically, these two guys are both, we were their only Division I offers. John Conchar, wow. We recruited him out of Chicago, and he was the leading scorer in the state of Illinois, but he was 6'4", 162 pounds. We redshirted him, added 45 pounds of muscle, and added more over his career. And now he's a fifth-year senior who weighs 215 pounds. Cason Harrell, our senior two-guard, he didn't play at all on a team that won our league and then comes back his sophomore year after just working his tail off and is seventh in the nation in three-point shooting. And, these are two young men. We beat Indiana in back-to-back years. 2 years ago, they were ranked number three in the country. Last year, we went down to Bloomington and beat them by 20 on the road. And, they're two guys that literally were under the radar, but they've gone to work, and they can really play. And you're exactly right. And I feel like we stole one out of Atlanta last year. Jared Godfrey from Sandy Creek is a freshman for us this year and started a handful of games, but plays a significant role right now coming off the bench. And I think he's going to be an absolutely tremendous player over his four-year career with us.
Yes, indeed. Like I said, Coach, there's a lot of talent here in Atlanta. That's why the Peach Jam is so big and these other terms we have out there in Lake Point, all these guys come to see these guys play here because the talent pool is here is very large because Georgia can't get everybody, so Texas can't get everybody. So you got a lot of players here who get overlooked by Kennesaw maybe or Mercer maybe or GS, Georgia State maybe. They can all come out, all leave here and play somewhere like Fort Wayne and develop and be good for 4 years, get a nice degree, and maybe play pro somewhere, not in maybe over in Europe somewhere or in Asia.
Right, right. Well, we've gotten guys that are hungry that are gym rats, and we've had 17 guys sign pro contracts in my 7 years here, and just really proud of the development that you talked about. That's something we've taken great pride in, and I'll be honest with you, I got a lot of my development stuff from my high school coach, Ron Bell at Marist High School, who in 1993 was the National High School Coach of the Year, and a great example of player development. I played with Matt Harpring in high school. That's my last claim to fame in playing, is that I was a senior, Matt was a sophomore, and Matt was the third string point guard that year. Obviously, he developed a lot better over the next couple of years than I did, playing in the NBA for over a dozen years. But it's really cool watching these young guys just spend time in the gym and dream and work and just evolve. And then those guys that get on to play at the next level, that's pretty cool.
Exactly, Coach. And I feel like a lot of young men who I go talk to different colleges around the area, I try to tell them, hey, every day you have to keep working at your craft to get better because there's somebody always going to be better than you. You have to chase the next guy. Always be hungry for the next best thing. Don't get complacent. Don't settle for what you are now. Try to be better the next day. Live every day as a new day to become a better person, a better player, or better whatever you do. Use each day you have to become better and learn something different to make yourself aware of an individual going forward in life.
It sounds like you've been hanging out in my locker room. I like it.
I may have, Coach. You never know. I'm not going to be anywhere.
Well, thank you so much for having me on. I appreciate it. And I got to get down there. I need to get down there actually as soon as possible. I got to get out of this cold weather for a little bit.
Now, Coach, when you come to recruit here, well, I know you will come. I'd love to have you come here to Northside Drive, where I'm at right now, to our studio in Midtown Atlanta here, and come in studio with us. Turn on the live stream, have the fans of Fort Wayne see you in studio with me and my staff, and we have a great time and just, talk Fort Wayne basketball. Let's talk life and just talk ball, man, because I love doing those things, Coach.
I would love to, and I know with your Orlando ties, we've had 7 first-team all-league guys from the state of Florida. Got 3 on our roster right now. We definitely can talk a lot about Southern hoops. We've done very, very well in Fort Wayne with some Southern guys.
Now, Coach, let me ask you this, Coach. Now, for a guy from Florida like myself or Atlanta, how do you sell a guy on the cold? Because I know for me, it was hard to go to Tennessee State because I was used to being in Florida. But I realized I wasn't going to play UCF football-wise. I was going to get on the field before my junior year, and I wanted to play. So I went down a level to FCS, Tennessee State, and got to play right away in Nashville. Now, it gets cold there, but not cold as it gets in Fort Wayne. So how do you sell a guy on the cold from Florida like myself?
Well, the difference between the route you went and what I'm trying to get players to do is that, we play basketball, which which is all indoors. And so you're not having to face that sort of issue of cold weather playing. You know, also the Summit League last year was ranked as high as the 12th best league in the country. And so you're getting mid-major plus basketball where, you know, you go into, you know, the state of Florida and even into Georgia where you have the Atlantic Sun. It's, you know, kind of a little bit of a notch above from top to bottom in the league, and or at least some of the perception or the RPI and the rankings. And so, you know, you get to sell that next level of basketball between, you know, the Horizon, the Summit, and the MAC is some of the best mid-major basketball, you know, in the country. You know, the other part is I don't know if you've ever been to Indiana, but we're a little bit basketball crazy up here. We got
very much so.
Nine of the largest high school gyms in the country are in Indiana. I got two assistant coaches that played at Muncie Central, all right, which is that's the school that was in the championship against Milan in the Hoosiers movie, and it was the big tool. They see 7,000 seats in their high school gym, and that's the 16th largest in the country. I recruited a young man from Newcastle High School last year, which is where Steve Alford played, and they have over 10,000 seats in their high school gym, and they pack it. I got to call ahead to make sure I get a reserved seat when I go watch a high school game in the state of Indiana because they'll sell out 4,000 to 8,000 seats. So there's just great enthusiasm. And you know, our guys, they're on the nightly news here. We'll have 2 to 3 TV cameras in our practice gym every day when we get into league play. You know, we're on TV every game. You know, there's a great bond. When we played Indiana at home 2 years ago, the year they were ranked number 3, we sold the game out in 45 minutes. And that's 12,000 seats. And we played in the old Detroit Pistons. I don't know if you knew this or not, but Fort Wayne is the home of one of the original NBA cities. The Detroit Pistons started in Fort Wayne. And so we just got a great tradition here, and people are basketball junkies. And so, you know, we really sell the basketball part of it to our recruits and the guys in the South. And the other thing is for those Florida guys we got, the nice thing is they got that Allegiant Air for $60 a direction trying to get, the snowbirds down there to Florida. And we just use it in reverse direction to get mom and dad up to watch them play.
Yeah, Coach, I was in Indianapolis on New Year's Eve with the Atlanta Hawks. So I was just there. Because I don't know if Derek tells you or not, I also work with the Hawks on their broadcast, doing on the radio side. So I'm with the Hawks and Falcons always. So Indiana That's Pacers awesome. Fans are always wild. The field house is always going crazy up there. So I enjoy it. It's one of my favorite trips of the year, going to Indiana. To see how the fans in Indiana always chill on their Pacers no matter what.
I'm a diehard Hawks, Falcons, Braves fan, and it was really cool. I was blessed during my time at Marist that Mike Fratello's kids were in high school with me. Bobby Kremen's kids were in high school with me. You know, a number of the coaches for the Falcons, their kids were in high school with me. And you know, actually, this is a big week for my high school showcasing in Atlanta. Sean McVay, a Marist grad, is bringing his Rams down to Atlanta. It's going to be a pretty cool weekend.
And, Coach, I hope you're cheering for the Rams. That's where I am. Because, Coach, I can't cheer for a Saint or a Patriot after what happens in Houston and what the Saints do to us all the time. I got to cheer for the Rams. And Coach Wade Phillips and Sean McVay. You got to, Coach.
No doubt. You know, and he gets all this credit for being you know, a great football coach. He was a heck of a football player himself. He was player of the year the same year that Calvin Johnson came out. That's pretty good representation.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Coach McVay. Now, Coach Coughlin, I'll tell you what, man. I hope you all beat South Dakota this week. And Oral Roberts, I love your energy, Coach. I love that we're on the same language, the same plane. We are Georgia guys, man. This is exciting, man. So I look forward to having you on the show again, Coach. You've been a great guest. Hope to get you in studio here in Midtown Atlanta when you come to town. So, Coach, when you come to town, look me up. I'm going to text you all after the show here so you can have information. Hopefully, you can link up here real soon, Coach.
Sounds good. Thanks for having me on today.
Thanks, Coach Coughlin. You have a great day. Talk to you real soon, man.
All right. Thanks. Take care.
for all your photo, video, and voiceover needs, check out the fine folks at Blu-ray Productions. They will take good care of you. If you don't believe me, you can see for yourself. Check out their work at blueberryproductions.tv, the Facebook page, Blueberry Productions, also a Vimeo page, a YouTube page, and it's Blueberry, B-L-U-B-E-R-R-Y, Prod on Twitter. Check them out today. Blueberry Productions, great people, great work, great service.
Hey there, your yard took a real beating this summer. Luckily, Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard has your back. Just feed your grass with Scott's again this fall when the air is cool and the soil is warm. It's the perfect time to give your lawn a boost. If you do, Winter Guard will give your yard the nourishment it needs to help weak, thin grass recover and support root growth, giving you a greener, more resilient lawn both now and next spring. Guaranteed. Grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard today. You'll be back to barbecuing in no time. This is a Scott's Yard.
Hey parents, we all try to be extra careful with our children in the car, but then we get an important call or text. Remember, our children are watching. Make every drive a good example. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWill24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
Show, we're joined by the coach of your Georgia State Panthers, Coach Ron Hunter. Coach Hunter, how are things over there on Decatur Avenue over there?
Things are going well, man, you know, trying to get this program back into the NCAA tournament this year, and like where my kids are, and getting ready for this stretch run.
Yes, indeed, Coach. You've been playing real well, coming off a victory this past weekend. You're 55th overall, 15-6, 6-2 in conference play. A great race for all your teams in the Sun Belt there. So, Coach, which your team? What's been the factors this year for your team playing so well so far?
Well, you know, we've been really consistent. We got a veteran team, and, you know, we kind of hit a little dip about a week and a half ago. But, you know, basketball is such a long season that you're going to have those kind of up and downs. And so we kind of hit our valley part. Now we're back to getting ready to go. And it's always important. Championship teams play well in February and March, and it's that time of year. And so we're ready to get going.
And Coach, especially at your level, Coach, being old and being good and old this time of year, like you said, February and March is so key. They've been through all those battles, been all through all those wars, and they don't feel like it's new to them. So I know you feel good about that with your guys who've been through all these battles with you all these years.
Yeah, no question. I mean, these guys were on that NCAA tournament team last year. We've got some guys that were on that team to beat Baylor. So, you know, this is an experienced basketball team. We've been through it. And, you know, a lot of times guys get overhyped for games and some of those things. And this group understands that, you know, you play your best basketball February, March, and good things are going to happen to you. So, so I like that. I like having a veteran team this way. And, you know, we don't have to, you know, we don't have to rah-rah them. These guys know when to get ready to play.
And, Coach, you feel like those close games you've played all this year. Some of you won, some of you lost, but these close games you're playing are going to help you as you go in February and March. Because when you feel good when it's tight, you can make that extra play, make the extra when it's tight, Coach. You can feel great about yourself. You know you can make the shot, you can make the play on defense. So how you feel about that with them tough games you played earlier this year already?
Yeah, no question. You know, we played a lot of close games, probably more than I wanted to play this year. But we this group, they know how to win those games. Whether it's at Alabama when you had to come back, or you know we had to hit a shot at home, to win a game. So we've been on them all year. We know how to play that way. I still like to win by 15-20. That makes it a bit easier, but it also helps that you know that no matter what the situation is, you know how to win those type of games. And that's been able to help us down the stretch. And I know it will, you know, when postseason play gets here, you know, because, again, you know, whether it's a Sun Belt team or a Power 5 team, we've been able to win regardless of who it may be.
And, Coach, let's speak about your team captain, Malik Ben-Levy, because I'll tell you what, Coach, he's been at the program the last few years. He's grown from a boy to a man from Savannah, Georgia. What's he meant to your program and to you personally, having him on your roster for all the guys around the program?
Oh, he's been great. He's the rock. You know, every program's got to have what you call that guy. That guy, regardless of what goes on the offensive end, defensive end, things are up or down, he's always going to be there, and that's Malik Ben-Levy. He's always been that way since he stepped foot on campus. He will be dearly missed after his time is done here in a few months here, but he's just been the rock of our program for the last 4 years.
Another guy I've seen grow, Coach, is Jeff Thomas. He scored over 1,000 points just a few games ago. And I know you got to be happy for Jeff, because I know you've got him as a young pup and grew him and developed him, and now you feel like a proud papa. Look at him playing for you. He's proud up there for you.
Yeah, there's no question. You know, we redshirted him his freshman year, and, you know, we're kind of going back and forth on that. But I tell you now, you know, having a fifth-year senior right now, and you know, he came in with that, you know, on that team that won it with when we beat Baylor, and now he can go out also on an NCAA tournament team. And that's how you want your college career to grow, you know, bookends where you can have an NCAA tournament run. And so I'm proud of Jeff. He's been terrific. You know, he's kind of followed in RJ's footsteps, and he's been a great player for us.
Yes, indeed, Coach. And look at your stats, Coach. I've seen you got 60 guys in double figures, which is rare in college basketball these days. 60 guys in double figures. You got guys rebounding well as well, led by Malik there, and DeMarcus scoring the most points for you guys. So with this year, would you get with Coach McCollum and Coach Williams, all your staff, and say, hey, we want to attack the glass this year and share the ball even more and be balanced on both ends of the floor so we can win games no matter what, grind it out, or outscore people if we have to?
Well, that's exactly right. If you look at the number of guys who led us in scoring, we've had different guys. I mean, DeMarcus, of course, leads us in scoring, but in different games. You know, last game, DeMarcus only scored 1 point and we won. We scored when DeMarcus had 30. We scored when he had 4 points. And so it's just not, you know, somewhere where you're going to say, I'm going to stop DeMarcus. You know, Kane Williams can beat you. We got a lot of different guys that can step up and beat you. That's what makes this team really, really special, because if you get to the point where you start focusing on one thing, we got other things that can beat you.
You got there right, Coach. It's good to have options no matter where they come from. So you try something, we can stop you. Either way you go, we got something for you, and I do it right there for you, Coach. I love that, Coach. And speaking of success, Coach, Malik, you know, DeMarcus, and Jeff, based on in your level, I feel like player development is so key to be at major level, because you got to get those guys, turn them into one blue-chip recruits, Coach, but turn them into great players by the time they graduate, like Jeff, and you got Malik. So for you and your staff, how much emphasis do you put on that player development piece, and what's kind of the plan that you go to get these guys from freshman, sophomore, to junior, to senior, to be where they're at now?
Well, it's important. You know, one of the things that we have to be, and we're teachers, and all of a sudden, if you're always worried about trying to recruit somebody better, then you're not doing a good enough job with the guys you got, make it better. And so one of the things that, you know, we love about our program is that all of our guys get better. A guy like Kane Williams wasn't heavily recruited, and he's having a great year. He's one of the best point guards in the Sun Belt right now. So whether it's Malik or whether it's Devin Mitchell, I mean, all of our guys that have come into our program have gotten better, and that's a testament to my staff. And so we're big on getting guys better, teaching them, and when it's their turn to play, they're ready to play.
And, coaches, Saturday's game. Big game, Georgia Southern. Your rivals coming to town. Now, what are you saying for them guys on film? Coach Byerton down there. And what she'll tell you guys this week is in practice to get ready to play those guys on Saturday. Not get too hyped up. Would it been your rival coming to town, GSU Sports Arena on Saturday around at 1 o'clock there?
Yeah, we don't have to get ourselves overhyped for this game. I mean, we got to win the game because it's a home game. We're fighting for another championship. I mean, the crowd will take care of itself in regards, you know, the energy in the building will be incredible. And so we won't get ourselves overhyped about this game, because what we got to do is we got to win this game because it's a home game. You got to take care of home to win a championship. We've already let one go. And so it's important for us to win this game because it's, you know, we're fighting for a championship and we just happen to be playing towards Southern.
And, Coach, you feel like your league is getting even better. I'm looking at the standings in the league, how the games are so very close. No matter who is playing, they're close games. It's great coaches. So for the league as a whole, Coach, you feel like it's getting better and better, and people overlooking your guys' league because it's a Sun Belt conference, not one of the Power 5 ones.
One of the most underrated conferences in the country. And it shows, just not this year, but over the years. Look at the number of pros that have come from this league. You got great coaches in this league. And so, again, if you look at even, you know, whether it's Little Rock or Georgia State, we're winning games in the NCAA tournament. So, again, this thing is extremely underrated, extremely balanced, really good talent. And this year is no exception.
And, Coach, how's RJ doing? I saw RJ sign with the Celtics G League team again on two-way contract with the Boston League. So how's he doing so far? And you happy to see him back in the league, even on a two-way deal there?
Yeah, you know, again, it's RJ's fighting that grind to that NBA professional life. It's extremely hard. If everybody could do it, you know, it wouldn't be the guys making, you know, that type of money. But he's doing great. You know, he's back with Boston, the team that drafted him. And so, he'll probably be with them toward the end of the year and when things kind of settle down a little bit. But really happy. You know, he just he's in that professional life and he's in that grind. That's not a bad life to be in. So I'm really proud of it.
That's what I got for you, Coach. Rams, Pats. Who you got Sunday, Coach?
Man, I got to go with the Patriots.
I hear that. Hey, I prefer the Rams because of what they did to us in Super Bowl in Houston. But I feel you, though. Brady's the GOAT, man. You can't go against him all the time. I speak out.
Yes,
come up with something amazing.
Yes, sir. No, it's not only Brady, but Belichick. Got one of the best coaches. And, man, you get one thing you can't teach is that experience. Can't go buy it. Can't teach it. And that's, you know, when you've been there 9 times, man, they know how to win those games.
Yes, indeed. But, Coach, have a great game on Saturday. I'll talk to you real soon, man. Best of luck to you down the road, Coach.
All right, buddy. Take care. God bless.
Thank you, Coach. It's Ron Hunter on the Bossman Show, people. Check him out. Saturday, GSU Sports Arena.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech and 313 Fresh, bringing you 2 discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today, True Speech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
A gorgeous tan from Suntan City gives you an inner glow that relights the fire when you run into your first crush.
Vicky, who is that?
An old boyfriend.
Lucky you just tanned at Suntan City.
Lucky he's single. We're doing lunch tomorrow.
Won't be single for long then.
During Tour of the City, try all 5 tans, including spray tan, for just $4.99. Restrictions may apply. Click to buy now.
When you're a teen, you finally get to make some of your own decisions. Who are you going to hang out with? What do you want to be? Are you going to glance at that text while driving? Remember, a split second is all it takes for something tragic to happen. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
Maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man JC, the host with the most, baby, and it goes down each and every Saturday night right here in the city of Memphis. That's right, y'all. It goes down at Clicks Sports Bar Memphis, baby, 3705 Malco Way, Memphis, Tennessee, 38125. Come out and join us, the Three Kings, each and every Saturday night for the livest karaoke in the city. Everybody gets in free till 10 p.m., only $5 after. Great food. We got drink specials. We got all kind of games, man. We got the pool tables popping. Whatever you want, we got you, man. Come on out. Have a good time with us each and every Saturday night. That's Clicks Sports Bar, Memphis.
Man, show be joined by a good friend of the show, the coach at Bethune Cookman, Ryan Ritter on the Bossman Show. Coach Ritter, how's life down in Daytona, man?
Hey, life in Daytona is going. We're right in the midst of our season, so trying to figure a way to get hot these last couple weeks of the season, man. How are you doing?
Coach, is going great here in ATL. I told you off the air, man. Super Bowl week is live and full effect, man. So it's enjoying the concerts, the parties, the people. It's been a great week so far.
Nothing wrong with that.
Now, Coach, I'll ask you, man, since it's your second year with Bethune-Cookman, last time we talked last year, what's the biggest difference in your program? How's your program grown and expanded since we last talked last year about your program from 1 year to 2 years?
Yeah, great question. You know, I think, you know, a lot of things have changed. Obviously, you know, we got the job, April of 2018. We were picked almost dead last in all the publications and ended up finding a way to have a heck of a year and were able to win a regular season championship. And so year one, that was something that was our program and our university. And then as you go into year two, our expectation stays the same in terms of we're trying to win a conference championship again. But I think our guys have worked really hard and we were actually preseason picked to win it this year. So I think in terms of outside perception, our guys have worked extremely hard to build a good product. And more than anything, I think it's just probably the outside expectation has been different. Although, our daily approach has been really the exact same.
Now, Coach, you get more calls from coaches about high school coaches, JUCOs about players now since, you won last year. You came in, you established, you got a good roster of junior and seniors this year, some JUCO guys, some transfer guys. So are you hearing from a lot of different coaches in high school ranks and JUCO ranks about trying to get players towards you since you guys came in, made that splash last year?
Yeah, that's been the greatest part. When we first took the job, it was, we went transfer and junior college route. And actually this fall, we were able to sign three high school kids, and they're all from winning programs in the state of Florida. I think us having some success specifically in the state of Florida, beating some of those schools in year one, Jacksonville, Stetson, FAMU playing very close to Miami, and knocking off Florida Atlantic this year. I think we were able to really get in our backyard and sell a good product, and ultimately able to get some really good high school kids, along with hopefully we'll sign a transfer or two here late.
Now, Coach, I feel like that your team has played so many close games this year. It's tough on your team over the season to execute in these tough spots. And I feel like as the games gain importance in February and March, you have an older roster of juniors, seniors, fifth-year guys, grad transfer guys. And, hey, even though you're 3-4 right there in conference, Norfolk State is 7-0, you still make a run to get hot right there in that tournament time up there in Norfolk when the MEAC time comes around in March there.
Yeah, definitely, JR. I think our roster is built for some adversity. I think we can definitely play better as a stretch. We've played five of our conference games on the road already. So we're excited to get back home. We got our next four at home. At the same time, we did have a couple tough injuries early on, and we're finally getting into a rhythm where we know our rotation, we know our guys, and I really do believe this team can make a heck of a run come February, March.
Yeah, Coach, like you said, man, having an older roster this time of year makes a big difference. And, you know, an injury or two here and there, the guys are not going to get down, but they're not going to throw them off the main mission to keep people focused. They say, hey, the bigger picture is let's peak late in February, early March, then MEAC tournament, because that can get us to where we want to go, to the big dance, or maybe catch Norfolk State in the standings, maybe get McGinnis in the NIT again.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, that's, you know, at the end of the day, it was special. We won a regular season championship, and that's our still number one goal. But like, you know, a majority of leagues in Division One, you know, we're going to be a one bid league. And at the end of the day, you can go 16-0, and if you falter in that first round of the NCAA tournament, you're going to fall short of your ultimate goal. So having, you know, we've got 8-9 guys that are playing minutes right now that are all juniors or seniors or grad transfers. So I really feel like this group's about to you know, play really good basketball, and we like each other. We're tight. We just, like you said, we got to execute down the stretch with some older guys, and I can't wait to see what happens here. You know, starting Saturday with NC Central.
And Coach, like you said, man, had playing 8 or 9 guys. Because, you know, some teams are playing, I'm seeing them playing 6 guys, 7 guys. You've been playing 8 or go 8 or 9 deep. So if something's not working on giving out, you got options, you know. I feel like sometimes coaches shorten the rotation too short sometimes. Playing 6.5 men, you know, it's not going to work. You know, having that 8th or 9th guy you can trust and put them out there when something's getting tough can really help you for foul trouble game, or if a guy gets hurt, you have the depth behind them to keep the train rolling there.
Yeah, absolutely. And what's crazy is, you know, we could really go 10 or 11 deep in terms of, you know, that much confidence in our roster. You know, so to have guys that you can look down the end of the bench and feel really good about putting in, I think it's definitely an advantage going into headed towards the postseason.
And, Coach, I was giving a speech at a high school the other day about, I got talking about being a player development coach. You know, had developing your players in the offseason, summertime, spring, even a season developing your players. So it's your level, Coach. How big an emphasis do you and your staff put on developing your players come spring and summertime and in season to get them, to break them? And it might not be a blue-chip recruit when they get to you, but by the time they leave, they can play at a Power 5 school, when they get stronger, working on their game, and they can max out at their level based on your program and how you develop those guys.
Well, that is one of the most important things in our program. You know, I think on the front end of things, recruiting and scheduling are absolutely huge in college coaching. You know, you got to have great players, and you got to have a schedule that, you know, allows you to have some success. But in terms of when we get those dudes on campus, skill development is definitely one of our top 1, 2, or 3 priorities, because at the end of the day, you know, we can call up all these nice sets and offense and defense and feel really good as about a coach. But at the end of the day, if those dudes aren't working on their game, you know, it's going to be really hard to execute them. So that is huge. Every single day we do skill development. Every day we practice, it's a part of our practice.
I hear that, Coach, because I'll tell you what, because, you know, I hate when a guy gets complacent with their skills. I'm like, you have to keep getting better. Even being a radio host, I try for us to get better every day as a radio host. Now, I play sports as well, but still, I always want to find a way to make myself better the next day. How can I get 1% better each day? And I feel like too many guys read those press, read the press, read the media, get on radio shows. Oh, yeah, I'm good. No, there are guys that are still busting their butts to be better than you now. So you have to always work on your craft no matter what it is.
Well, you said it. I mean, that's everyday life. You want to coach, you want to be a lawyer, you want to be a father, you want to be whatever you want to be. I mean, you got to work at that thing. And that's the message we've got to our guys. And quite honestly, you know, we've got some guys that are, transfers or maybe on their second chance. And I think they relish in the moment. They don't get complacent about, you know, hey, I finally made it to Division One. I think it's, hey, I'm now that I got here, I'm freaking hungry. I'm ready to work. And you know, skill development for them particularly, you know, it's huge.
And Coach, like you said, you mentioned earlier Saturday you played NC Central. I mean, Coach Moten's done always have a great team up there with his guys. And so what are you seeing for them guys on film this year, man, if it's a game on Saturday? And what are you telling your team to get ready to play these guys? Because those guys have been perennial in the MEAC, always up near the top, always playing well, always causing a challenge. So what are you telling your guys about playing NC Central this week, Coach, at your place?
Well, it's funny because Coach Moten's actually one of my mentors. He's a guy that's really helped me throughout the years. It's funny, he's been on some of my references for some of my jobs. So That's my man. I got unbelievable respect. You said it. They are, one of the perennial teams in the MEAC every single year. It doesn't matter who's on his roster, freshman, sophomore, junior, senior. Talent-wise, they're going to be – you look at those standings, they're going to be towards the top. And I think that's, a tribute to how well he does, with that program. But the one thing that you see is you see consistency with them. They got guys that are going to do their job. You know, if their guy is supposed to shoot, he's going to shoot. If the guy's supposed to rebound, he's going to rebound. They are very – very, very good in what they do. And obviously this year they guard very, very well. That's been a staple of their program. But more importantly than that, I think they just really believe in each other. And you can see in the way they play. So it's going to be a heck of a battle Saturday. They got us up at their spot this year. I think they won by 9 or 7 or 9 earlier this year. And so I think, the atmosphere will be awesome Saturday, and hopefully it'll be a heck of a contest.
Now, Coach, can you speak about how the MEAC has improved from top to bottom, even with the departure of Hamilton to the Big South? I felt the conference is still getting stronger, getting better. You've seen the records of non-conference getting better. So I feel like the whole league as a whole has been tougher in general. So talk about that a little bit, how this conference has gotten better from top to bottom this year, even losing a team like Coach Joyner and Hampton Pirates there.
Yeah, obviously, losing Hampton is tough. They do a heck of a job. They're having decent success in the Big South. But in terms of our league, NC Central, teams like that, they can go and play at a majority of mid-major levels. But I think the thing you're seeing, too, is we've got some new coaches in the league that are in year two, year three, year four, that are really starting to have, get a hold on their program and a stamp. Obviously, you've got, Coach Bossman, Coach Rob Jones at Norfolk, Coach Mota Central. Those are staples. Every year, those dudes are going to be good. And then I think you've got some other guys that are really not just upgrading talent, but really upgrading programs. And I'm excited to see, obviously we're 3-4 right now. So it's a pretty tough league, hence we were picked to win it. And we've already, seen our struggles, specifically on the road this year.
That's what I got for you, Coach. Super Bowl prediction time. Rams or Pats? Who you got, Coach?
Man, I gotta go with the Pats.
I hear that. Hey, you can't beat the guy that's been there 9 times, right? You got to go with him until somebody beats him.
You got it. Until he gets beat, I'm going to go with him every single time.
I hear that, Coach. I'll be there on Sunday. I'll see it live in color one more time. I've already seen him rip out my heart one time in Houston, so I know what he's capable of because I missed it myself.
Oh, man. Well, yeah, I think it'll be a heck of a game. I wouldn't mind seeing the Rams win, but it's hard to go against Tom Brady, so. I'm going to go Pats on Sunday.
I hear that, Coach. Good to talk to you. As always, Coach Ritter. I hope you guys beat Coach Moten on Saturday. Get your season on the up so you can get on that run that you want to get on, man.
I appreciate it. Great talking with you.
All right, Coach. Anytime, buddy. Folks, it's Ryan Ritter here on the Bossman Show.
All your photo, video, and voiceover needs, check out the fine folks at Blue Ray Productions. They will take good care of you. If you don't believe me, you can see for yourself. Check out their work at blueberryproductions.tv, the Facebook page, Blueberry Productions, also a Vimeo page, a YouTube page, and it's Blueberry, BLUBERRY, prod on Twitter. Check them out today. Blueberry Productions, great people, great work, great service.
Hey there, your yard took a real beating this summer. Luckily, Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard has your back. Just feed your grass with Scott's again this fall when the air is cool and the soil is warm. It's the perfect time to give your lawn a boost. If you do, Winter Guard will give your yard the nourishment it needs to help weak, thin grass recover and support root growth, giving you a greener, more resilient lawn both now and next spring. Guaranteed. Grab a bag of Scott's Turf Builder Winter Guard today. You'll be back to barbecuing in no time. This is a Scott's Yard.
Hey, parents, we all try to be extra careful with our children in the car, but then we get an important call or text. Remember, our children are watching. Make every drive a good example. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
Hello, my name is Travis Williams, President and CEO of Academics and Athletic Consulting, focusing on educating and empowering tomorrow's collegiate athletic leaders. My passion is for the education and genuine concern and care for today's student athlete. It's the centerpiece of my life's work. A college education, both in and out of the classroom, is a truly rewarding benefit. For more information on AAC, you can go to www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Once again, www.academicsandathleticsconsulting.com. Or you can follow me on Facebook at Academics and Athletic Consulting, or Twitter at Coach TWheel24, or Instagram Travis L. Williams 24. Or you can call me at 404-542-607. Once again, AAC is very proud to partner with J.R. McHenry of the Bossman Radio Show, covering sports and entertainment across the country. Please tune in weekly for informative, entertaining, and expert analysis on today's sports and entertainment topics. Thank you.
JR the Boss Man Show. We're joined by the coach of Lipscomb Bisons, my mom's alma mater, as you all know, Casey Alexander. Coach Alexander, how are things going in Nashville, man?
Doing well. How things down there?
Coach, it's very live down here. It's football week, man, and I'm enjoying Radio Row. I'm enjoying the whole ambiance, man. I'm just having a blast.
Have fun with it. It's a good time of year, for sure.
Yes, indeed. Coach, well, you guys are 8-0 in A-Sun play, a big win against Liberty, who was also 7-0. So, what's been the key factor for you this year, Coach, for you and your guys being so well-oiled machine, non-conference play playing well as well, and now conference play 8-0 so far? What's been the key factors for you, Coach?
Well, we returned a lot of experience off an NCAA tournament team from last year, all five starters and 7 out of our top 8 or 9, and so a lot of guys that have played a lot of meaningful minutes and had good success, but better than that, they've come to work every day and had an agenda to get better, improve individually, improve as a team, and so it's gone really well to this point.
And talk about it a little bit, Coach, the player development piece of it, Coach. I feel like at your level, Coach, you got to be a player development specialist and expert, because at your level you have to get your guys in as freshmen and grow their craft, grow them as men, and grow their bodies, grow their skill and talent. So for you and your program, how big an emphasis is it to develop these guys to the point that they're older junior seniors now and can help you help win games, these big games against some high-rated teams, even in your conference, tough games, that can get the job done because they're not scared, they're not fearful?
Yeah, well, it's definitely a process, and that's the first thing you have to realize quickly is, it takes a lot of work. A lot of effort, takes a lot of time to build the relationship more than anything. You know, anybody can get in the gym and get shots up and work on their craft and so forth. But, it's important that you spend a lot of time with your players. It's important that they understand, what you want in your program and how to go about doing things and, kind of what your identity is within the team and that sort of thing. And so it's a never-ending process. It's great to watch it develop right in front of your eyes. And, unfortunately for us, we've had a lot of kids. We've had guys that come in as freshmen and leave as seniors. Very few transfers. Only two in my time that I've been in for 6 years, and we've only had one staff change in that amount of time. So when you have that kind of continuity, it gives you a great chance, to just keep getting better as opposed to having to start over or rework on things from year to year.
And Coach, like I said, also your team's been tough and by some tough losses, I'll be like, Coach, because you all could have beat Belmont, you could have beat Louisville, just a play or two here and there cost you those games, but just to think that how great you guys played against those two teams who are great in their own rights and still hung tough with them, and just they made a play or two differently, they can say you guys have a different record, because it's only one game you really didn't play that well in and lost. So how you feel about that, Coach, knowing that your team really played well all year long?
Yeah, well, we've been, you know, those are good teams, you know, I mean, Louisville's a top 20 team right now, and Belmont's a top 50 team right now, or close to it, and so, you know, you got to play your best when you, if you're going to win those games, and you're right, we did have a chance to win all three of them, literally in the last minute, and have a chance to tie and win the game in all three of those games, and didn't do it, but that's just the nature of the season, you know, there have been games that we've won that have been close down the stretch, and I'm sure there will be plenty more, so, you know, you just kind of take the good with the bad. You got to learn from both sides of that equation and just keep having your team get better. But it's been a remarkable season, you know, when you look at it. I mean, you got those three losses right there that we could have won all three of them. The Clemson game at their place was really the only one that we didn't have a fighting chance in the last media timeout. So it's been good overall.
Yes, indeed. And, Coach, as we move into these later stages of season, February and March here, you have an experienced roster. I feel like it's going to really help you guys going forward because guys are not fearful. They don't execute and know what you expect to get the job done. So do you feel confident as well knowing, hey, February and March, my guys are back?
Man, I'm sorry. I know that happened.
Hey, Coach, finish it off there, Coach, before I back here.
Well, you know, I feel like better players you know, they understand the longevity of a season, and they understand that regardless of what happens now, I mean, we've had a good year to this point, and being undefeated in the league and 8-0 or 9-0 or whatever we are is good. But nobody, a month from now, nobody's going to care where we sit right now, you know. And so it's important to keep the end goal in mind. It's important to keep working toward achieving that goal by getting better every day and continuing to improve as a team. And fortunately for us, you know, experience helps that. You know, I don't have to do all the preaching and I don't have to sell a dream. These guys have been around before and they understand what it takes and they understand that it can happen. And so that's that makes my job a little easier when you've got that kind of experience and leadership in the roster.
And, Coach, if you could, just highlight some guys on your roster for my listeners who may not watch your team like I do. Who are some guys that are being key to your roster this year, man?
Well, Garrison Matthews is a senior wing for us, preseason player of the year in the A-Sun, and he'll have to fall hard if he's not the player of the year when it's all said and done. Just a remarkable score for us. We've got another senior five-man. He's undersized, but he's also an all-conference player. Rob Marbury is his name. Scored 1,000 points in just 2.5 years for us, and really a good threat down low. Those two guys are a great 1-2 punch. Then we've got great role players. I mean, we got guys that like Eli Pepper, that's our all-time leading rebounder in our D1 history, is our four-man. We've got two junior guards that have played a ton of minutes. So we've got a really good and balanced roster with a lot of guys that have made real contributions to Lipscomb's basketball program.
And, Coach, you got North Alabama, a new member of the A-Sun, coming to town for the first time to play you guys as an A-Sun member. What do you say for Coach Pujol and his team on film? And what are you telling your guys as you get ready to play this folk for the first time at Al Arena over there?
Yeah, well, I'm really impressed with what they've done to this point. You know, he's got those guys believing in what they're doing, you know, and it's a remarkable thing. I mean, basically 7 out of the 10 guys that they play are freshmen. And, you know, that's a hard ship to navigate when you're playing your first year of Division I basketball. But they found some success here lately. They've won 5 league games already, and they've done it just by playing hard. They play a full 40 minutes, and when you do that, you're going to give yourself a chance to win more times than not.
That's what I got for you, Coach. It's the A-Sun of me, Coach, has gotten better. You lost upstate, but you gained Liberty, North Alabama. From top to bottom, the league is getting better, in my opinion. How you feel about that on your side, being deep into it as a coach in that league there?
Yeah, I agree. I think our league from top to bottom is as good as it's been in a while. The addition of Liberty, you know, last night we go into that game and both of us are in the 40s in the net rankings and in the KenPom. By beating them on the road, we're now 36. I think they're in the 50s now, maybe high 50s. So you got two top 60 teams in the same league for a mid-major conference. That's pretty strong. But Florida Gulf Coast is still extremely talented. North Florida's got a lot of experience on their roster. NJIT's already won 15 games maybe. So it's a good league, and it'll
I expect it to be a fight all the way to the end.
Well, Coach, good luck to you on Saturday, Coach. I know you got it running somewhere here real soon. Thank you for still making some time for us tonight. And I'll talk to you real soon, Coach. Good luck as always. I'll always cheer for you guys. Oh. This is my mama's school, so I'll always cheer for you guys.
There you go. I always enjoy it. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Casey.
Hip-hop fans, I got a great album for you. The debut album from Family Grind ENT, True Speech, and 313 Fresh. We're going to give you two discs, 33 songs of pure, genuine hip-hop. Albums available on iTunes, Amazon, Google Play, illstreetrex.com, and streaming live right now on Rhapsody, Beats Music, Spotify, Xbox Music, Slacker Radio, and SoundCloud. Check them out today, True Speech and 313 Fresh, Family Grind ENT. Believe in it. Get it.
A gorgeous tan from Suntan City gives you an inner glow that relights the fire when you run into your first crush.
Vicky, who was that?
An old boyfriend.
Lucky you just tanned at Suntan City.
Lucky he's single. We're doing lunch tomorrow.
Won't be single for long then.
During Tour of the City, try all 5 tans, including spray tan, for just $4.99. Restrictions may apply. Click to buy now.
When you're a teen, you finally get to make some of your own decisions. Who are you going to hang out with? What do you want to be? Are you going to glance at that text while driving? Remember, a split second is all it takes for something tragic to happen. Be in the zone. Turn off your phone. Visit childrenshospital.vanderbilt.org/BITZ to learn more about our Teen Driver Safety Program. Brought to you by Monroe Carroll Jr. Children's Hospital at Vanderbilt, the Ford Motor Company Fund, and the Allstate Foundation.
It's maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer. All the stars are closer.
Tell me what you gonna do to me. Confrontation ain't nothing new to me. You could bring a bullet, bring a sword, bring a morgue, but you can't bring the truth to me.
Alexa, play Kendrick Lamar and SZA.
Okay.
Maybe the night that my dreams might let me know. All the stars are closer.
With Amazon Music, a voice is all you need. Get tens of millions of songs. Download the Amazon Music app today.
Yeah, yeah, it's your man JC, the host with the most, baby, and it goes down each and every Saturday night right here in the city of Memphis. That's right, y'all. It goes down at Clicks Sports Bar Memphis, baby. 3705 Malco Way, Memphis, Tennessee, 38125. Come out and join us, the Three Kings, each and every Saturday night for the livest karaoke in the city. Everybody gets in free till 10 p.m., only $5 after. Great food. We got drink specials. We got all kind of games, man. We got the pool tables popping. Whatever you want, we got you, man. Come on out. Have a good time with us each and every Saturday night. That's Clicks Sports Bar, Memphis.